Welcome back to Solomon's Vineyard. I am yours truly, Mr. Russell Mack. Haven't saw you guys in a while. It's been about a day or two, isn't it? But I am glad to be back. I have had some rough days. I got some things going on in my family, but we are okay. All right, but me and Talia are back. And I'm glad that you stopped by for this old school Sunday edition. And this is edition 12. And today we're going to talk about a couple of fragrances. We're going to do something a little different. We're going to talk about some of the fragrances that we have viewed and talked about throughout these 12 episodes of Old School Sunday. Now, some we haven't talked about, but some we have, at least most of them we have. So I want you to stick around, all right, and hang out with us for a little while. I got my helper, Talia's back with me, and we're ready to talk frags. So, we will see you on the other side of the clip after our opening song. Come on, family. It's Old School Sunday. Welcome back to Old School Sunday. This is Solomon's Vineyard with your host, Russell Mack, and
Talia.
That's my helper, guys. She's with me. We are feeling well. We're doing good. And I do realize it's a little later than usual, us doing Old School Sunday, but we are here. And first, I want to invite you that if you're new to the channel and this is your first time tapping onto Solomon's Vineyard and you have stumbled on this Old School Sunday edition, why don't you feel free to subscribe? Okay, there's a notification bell right below the subscription button. Tap on that notification bell, and you will get all notifications from this channel when I upload to your feed, and you can come and watch Russell Mack and Talia here on Solomon's Vineyard. Don't forget to thumbs up the video. We need that. Guys, I need you to like the video. And I need you to comment down below. You can participate in the comment thread. Your sin of the day or your SOD, as we call it, or SOTN, sin of the night. Feel free to list that down below or any new fragrances that you have discovered, you want me to know about, something you want me to talk about, or something I need to get on. That happens all the time. I have several of my YouTubers and subscribers who always recommend fragrances to me. One of them is Musky Oud. King Tai recommended that one, and I have been certainly enjoying that one. Julio Ayala, he tells me about fragrances all the time. So that's welcomed, okay? It's how we learn on this fragrance journey. And listen, guys, there are so many fragrances out on the market now. I give up on saying the best fragrance ever because you're going to always run into a fragrance that just as good as that one. So, you know, and we're ever learning. We are ever finding new fragrances, new houses are coming out. There are new niche houses. There's a house that I was told about by Julia Ayala called Michael Malua. And there's a fragrance there. A couple of fragrances that I've looked at that I'll be putting my hands on real soon. So, Precious Liquid is another house that I'm getting into, you know, Argos. So it's just a lot of houses that got some lovely fragrances. And then I'm finding that you're finding cheap fragrances that don't cost nothing. And they smell just as good as most niche or most designer fragrances. So now I'm just smelling them and wearing them, loving them, and collecting them, you know. So welcome back. And today we're going to do something different. I'm not going to do one fragrance as we normally will highlight one fragrance, and perhaps we'll go back to that next Sunday. But today we are going to take a look at some of our past compositions that we've talked about over the last 11 episodes of Solomon's Vineyard. This is episode 12. So what I did was I put together a list of some that we've already talked about and then some that we have seen on regular lists, but they smell good. And what I did, I want to walk from 1978 all the way up to 2014. So that's how we're going to do it. I hope you guys enjoy it. Let's get into the fragrances. The first two I'll look at is came out in 1978. This is Polo, and I'm talking about Polo because of their recent acquisition. The 2021 version of Polo Cologne Intense by Ralph Lauren. Well, I thought I'd talk about this one just to remind me of what I loved about Polo Green when it was released back in 1978. Back in 1978, I was 2 years old. So I grew up with this fragrance in the house, smelling it all the time on my dad. I would go over to my uncle or my grandmother's house. My grandfather and uncles, they loved this fragrance. Now, of course, the formulation is nothing like it is now, but I will say this does give you the smell of the original DNA, okay? I'm not going to really get into the notes. We know that there are a lot of notes in this fragrance. So many notes that I think I counted like 20-something notes, okay? But one of the main notes is that pine needle note and tobacco and oak moss is very recognizable in this fragrance. And if I had to just give this color, this fragrance a color, it would be the color of the bottle. This is a green machine, green beast. If you will, Polo by Ralph Lauren, a classic fragrance. You must have it. If you don't have it, if you collect it, you need to have this. 1978, very good fragrance, still to this day. Earthy fragrance, complex fragrance, but great fragrance. And being that we have the new release from Polo, and I know it's a lot modern, it's still green. But it you know, it's for people who don't really know about Polo. You got the younger generation that's come along now, and they're not going to really cleave to this Polo. I can tell you right now they're not. But they'll call it old man and have an old folk smell. And I expect that from them. But the one that's been released 2021, they can identify with it. The ambroxan, you know, the sage and thyme and all those green notes, the violet leaf. So it kind of made sense. Now, I don't know if they should have called it Intense, but that's a whole nother story. So this is Polo Green, the original, 1978. You guys know this iconic bottle, this iconic top. You know it, you know the smell. Let's move on to our next 1978 release, Lagerfeld. By Lagerfeld. What can I say about it? Spraying a little bit of it for you guys. Musky. Very, very musky. This is back when they were using real musk. You can show the crowd, show our viewers to leave the bottle. Oh my God. Very musky, very strong, guys. And I can tell you, this is another one with a whole lot of notes, but what you mainly get in is that strong muskiness, tobacco, and rose out of that fragrance. There is some oak moss. I think there is some civet in here, but real elegant, real classy. I still would rock this now. If I'm dressing up and I've got an important meeting, or I just want to, or if I'm taking a walk up out in the woods, in the trails, because every now and again, I'll do that. I'll go and hook up with some of my friends and we'll go drive out to the country. And we'll walk throughout the woods, not really hunting, just walking, just enjoying the evening, especially on a beautiful Sunday like today. I'd wear this one. Yeah, very, very classy, classic fragrance. And it's been around for a very long time. And I'm pleased and I'm happy to have this in my collection. Lagerfeld by Lagerfeld. All right, next one. So that was what, 1978. Now we're going to tiptoe into 1981, and this is, here you go to live, This is Quorum by Antonio Pugue. This is not, now from what I was told, and that's and what I was told was true. This is the new bottle. Now I don't know how new, but hey, I'm so glad I still have it. I'm getting the smell, and I don't know, people talking about the formulations, but this stuff is still strong. Now, I'm not gonna get into any technicalities, but maybe there is a note that you don't smell as prominent as we used to. But it's very rare that any of these fragrances from those times, they're not formulated the way they used to be. But I can tell you now, you will get a musky, clean, very soapy, what I love, that Irish Spring DNA is in this fragrance. Elegant fragrance, earthy, classy, outdoors, jump out of the shower kind of soapiness. You got that vetiver in this fragrance. Man, real nice. It was a bomb when it came out. And the next one we'll talk about, it was too. This is Quorum by Antonio Pugue. We talked about this on Old School Sunday. Also, we talked about the Aqua. So, here's another one that you need to have. If you're a collector and you like collecting nostalgic fragrances, this is another great one. Quorum by Antonio Pugue. All right. 1980 what, Talia? This is
1982,
guys. This is Drakkar Noir. There you go, Talia. You can show them. That's my little mini bottle. 1982, guys. That was another fragrance that was released. Look at that. It's very musky. A lot of these fragrances, from Polo up to this one, has a very potent musk or note in it. It could be civet, but it's very animalic, very musky, earthy, regal, rugged. I love it. But this one here also have that clean, soapy vibe that was very popular back in the early 80s. So those of you who was around back in those times, you will appreciate this video because you remember that was the DNA in the 80s, the early 80s. So this is Drakkar Noir, yeah, by Drakkar. Wait, I didn't even get the name. Who was that by, Talia? Drakkar Noir.
By Guy LaRouche.
Guy LaRouche. There you go. All right. I'm trying to make sure she's on, y'all. All right. Next one. 1985, right?
Yes, sir.
And this year, we talked about this one not too long ago on Old School Sunday. This is Boss Number One. Just want to spray a little tidbit. There you go, Talia. That's the first Hugo Boss to ever come out. And again, that musk. But this one opens up a little bit different, guys. This one opens up, you can tell the musk is there, but it's not as prominent in the opening. But you get a clean, fresh, soapy, kind of earthy type of scent in the opening with some floral notes. The musk, this dries down to a beautiful musk soapiness later in the fragrance, and I'm glad I ran across this one, man. I had forgot all about this one, and when I was looking at the fragrances that I'd use, I saw this one and I hurried and grabbed it because I love it. I love it. I actually wear this one often, so I haven't really dented it. You know, it's gonna take a while for me to dent these bottles because I only use maybe one or two sprays. This here can be dangerous in the high heat. Dangerous in close proximity with other people, especially if they don't know about the fragrances, man. And trust me, I know. I messed around and did that with Paul Sebastian one day and came out of the room. I had the whole hall lit up. So I had to come back in here and try to wash it off some. So Hugo Boss, number one. I love it, though. I love it. As a collector, I'm glad to have it, all right? Now, this is 1980 what, to live?
1988.
Groundbreaking, y'all. We right at 1990. This is Dior Fahrenheit. There you go, Talia. By Dior. Iconic fragrance, guys. What can I say about this fragrance? Man, that petroleum smell with from the hawthorn and cassius and the violet. And oh, my God, that violet screams in this fragrance. And this is actually my scent of the day. 1988 release from Dior. Dior has always made groundbreaking smells, groundbreaking scents, scents that others follow. But this one here, to date, haven't been copied, haven't been duplicated. If it has, I haven't smelled it. But it's hard to get this DNA. My goodness. And I don't think that it's not that it's people, houses don't want to copy it. I just think that the scent is so iconic. It's so recognizable. It's so unique. There's only one Fahrenheit, all right? And I know there's a Eau de Parfum, which I will have soon. So it's a new one. It's a newer release. It's smoother than this one, but it still has the DNA. But today, I'm rocking this one. I rocked this all day long, y'all. And it's so good. Dior Fahrenheit 1988. All right. We're almost done, guys, with Old School Sunday. Now, here's one we haven't talked about. And I don't know if I talked about it or not on this channel. I don't think I did. But this came out in, come on, Talia, what you say?
2002.
2002, guys. So we entering into the 2000s. And we got two frags left, all right? This is Alfred Song, He. Now, there may be some musk in this one, but this is another DNA that I absolutely love. What happens here in this fragrance, now, the top, man, this top is so funny. There we go. Oh, it's so pleasant. Such a pleasant scent. My mother loves this fragrance. And it is Alfred Song He. As I said, this came out in 2002. Clean. They turned the musk down in here. You got a really beautiful, clean, floral, crisp, wow, mild scent that is, I'm trying to pick it up in the air, y'all. Very unique. It has some earthy quality to it, some earthy nuances. Very green. This is a green fragrance. But it's beautiful, guys. The sillage from it, especially on a spring afternoon or a summer evening, I'm telling you, it is a compliment getter. I may spray this. I may put this on tonight. I forgot how good the smell. Asian House. I maybe need to talk about this one a little bit more. So I may preview this again. But this is Alfred Song He. Don't sleep on this fragrance. Very, very clean, very fresh, soapy. If you like, it even has a powdery quality to it that you might like. It's not overly powdery, but very clean, very inviting and warm. Real, real nice fragrance, guys. Especially if you like to go out and sit on the beach, this would be really nice to spray on now. So I don't know if I want to call it blue or green. But I know it has green notes in it, but it is a blue fragrance. So, Alfred Song He by Alfred Song. All right. Two more. This one came out in 2011. And I'm just about done, guys. And this is none other than this bottle here. Now, this is a newer bottle. I looked at the batch on this one. This came out. This bottle here is from 2019. I think, what you said? 19 what, Talia?
The seventh month.
So this is a 2011 juice. I don't have the bottle from 2011, okay? But this is Dior Homme by Christian Dior. And I don't know what made me put this on the list, but it's empty though. It's almost, I got a little bit left, and I'm going to use the rest of it. Here you go, Talia. That's the. And I had this bottle. I was holding on to it for JP. So I have it, but I'm going to spray the rest of that juice out. Gorgeous, gorgeous, look, masterpiece, powdery. It has that leather, that lipsticky iris in it, lavender, tobacco, leather, gorgeous cacao note. We all know about this Dior Homme. I don't know what else I can say about it. It was groundbreaking when this fragrance came out. It's the Parfum is one of the release is one of the most sought after fragrances in the game. Now, I don't know if people have calmed down and stopped looking for it as much because there are so many clone houses now that have it. Now, I have a decant that JP sent me from 3-in-1. And currently, right now, that's one of my faves. Real nice. But I got to have this one, okay? Now, I do have the 2020 Dior Homme, which I'll talk about that in a later video. The smell is a little bit different. Now, this one, though, I'm not going to spray it because I don't have much, y'all. But for some reason, I get 7-8 hours, sometimes 9 hours, I can still smell this. Don't ask me why, okay? I can't tell you. But what I can tell you is that this fragrance here does have parfums oils in it. Probably, and last I check, I think it was like 9 or 10, between 10 and 12%. So, I don't know if I'll ever be able to find this again, but I'm going to try, okay? Dior Homme by Dior. My last fragrance came out in 2014, and it's just got that nostalgic feel and vibe, an old school vibe to it. Here you go, Tamir. That's by Jacques Bogart, and it's One Man Show Oud Edition. Red Thyme opens this fragrance up. Very, very strong performer, room filler. This is one I know I'm not going to wear until it's cold. It can choke you out, apart from all of that, this is a beautiful fragrance. Very, that red thyme with oud, tobacco. Oh man, opens so beautiful, powdery. Very powdery, but it's beautiful with the red thyme note, and you do catch the oud there. Just a well blended fragrance, somewhat green, earthy, very complex, challenging. This stuff is dense, pungent when you first spray it, but it's good. You know, it's good. I know, you know, people talk about the strong openings from some of these fragrances, how pungent and powerful they are. But that's what I like, yo. That's what I like. And then when they begin to dry down, what I find it is that fragrances like this one, this One Man Show Oud Edition, what I find is, though it's pungent when it opened and somewhat medicinal, the dry down, it takes so long for it to dry down. And by the time you get to the heart, that's when the beauty of the fragrance really kicks in. So I'm not against it. I understand people that are put off from openings like that one. You know, I get it. Some people just they can't deal with that, you know, for allergy's sake and for other reasons, you know. And then just sometimes just don't like it. So I get that part. So, and being that we know that frags are subjective, you know, I can understand that people don't like certain fragrances. Heck, there are certain fragrances I'm not really a big fan of. Not going to say I'm a hate on them, though, or rag on them, but, you know, I do understand it. So, 2014, so that's our last fragrance, guys. So, I did that because I didn't upload yesterday, I don't believe. I uploaded a video Saturday, Friday night, so I think that was the last one I uploaded. And you guys, if you've been watching, y'all know I've been putting some work in, okay? So, I want to take some time out for myself, but then I wanted to correct some things here at you know, in my family. I had to take care of some personal matters with my family, and I did it, okay? You guys was on my mind and my heart, and thank you all for being around. I'm 2 from my goal, but I'm right at 200 subscribers, guys. Thank you so much, man, for the love. So come on, so we can start our next goal, all right? Thank you so much for joining me. I love you so much. I'll see you soon for another fragrance preview. This has been Old School Sunday, guys. I'm Russell, and you are?
Talia.
Talia Johnson, my baby. We'll see you guys later.
Bye.
Peace, fam. All right.